history about metabolic significance of PP pathway and difference between glycolysis and PP pathway. In the first part of this video, we have seen the reactions of PP pathway. Now, what's the difference between glycolysis and PP pathway? Because the precursor for the glycolysis and PP pathway is glucose 6-phosphate. Okay. So, glycolysis pathway, all of you know that it occurs in all types of tissues, whereas PP pathway occurs in certain special tissues like red blood cells, then testes, ovary, etc. Then glycolysis pathway is not a multicyclic process, it's a linear pathway, whereas PP pathway is multicyclic process. Then in the glycolysis pathway oxidation is done by dehydrogenation, but NAD plus is electron acceptor, and in case of PP pathway, oxidation again done by dehydrogenation, but NADP plus is used as electron acceptor. That's the main difference point. Okay. Then another important point is glycolysis pathway ATP is required and it is produced also. But in PP pathway, it is not meant for energy production. ATP is not produced. Then in glycolysis pathway, carbon dioxide is never formed, but in PP pathway, carbon dioxide is produced. Okay, so these are the some difference point between glycolysis and PP pathway. And for both the pathway, glucose 6-phosphate is an intermediate or second intermediate of glycolysis pathway, and it is the starting material for the PP pathway. Okay, now we will see the metabolic significance of HMP pathway. As already I have told you that this pathway is not meant for energy. That means what is the significance of this pathway? Actually, the end product of this pathway is very important for another processes. For example, one of the end product of this pathway is NADPH, and this NADPH is used as electron donor in many reductive synthesis in the body. For example, for the biosynthesis of fatty acids and cholesterol, etc. NADPH is used as electron donor. Okay, and this NADPH always comes from PP pathway. The second end product of this pathway, that is pentoses, ribose sugars are produced through this pathway, and these pentose sugars are very important component of nucleotides and nucleic acids. So these are required for the biosynthesis of nucleotide and nucleic acid. So during the process of biosynthesis of nucleotides and nucleic acid, pentose sugars which required is come from PP pathway. Okay, then third more important role of this PP pathway is role in red blood cells fragility. Okay, actually the NADPH produced through this pathway protects cell from oxidation damage by hydrogen peroxide and superoxide free radicals. All of you know that through metabolic reactions, hydrogen peroxide and other free radicals are produced, and this hydrogen peroxide are removed through catalase activity, which degrade it into water and carbon dioxide. And this catalase activity, as well as glutathione peroxidase which present in red blood cells, require NADPH as an electron donor. Okay, so if there is no NADPH, then due to peroxidation of lipid membrane or red blood cells membrane, it may cause break the red blood cells, due to which hemolysis of red blood cells occurs and it causes hemolytic anemia. Okay, so we can see here the role of NADPH in red blood cells fragility. Hydrogen peroxide produced through different metabolic reactions in red blood cells in presence of glutathione peroxidase enzyme, it breaks into two molecules of water molecule. Okay, and actually glutathione oxidized into reduced form of glutathione oxidized, and this oxidized glutathione converted back into reduced form with the help of NADPH, which actually provide the electrons for their oxidation and oxidize into NADP plus. Now, from where this NADPH comes from? It comes from the first reaction of PP pathway, that is conversion of glucose 6-phosphate to 6-phosphoglucono delta lactone in presence of glucose 6-phosphate dehydrogenase enzyme. For the continuation of the reaction, this NADP plus again reduced into NADPH, this NADPH reduce this glutathione so that it can break down the hydrogen peroxide into two molecules of water. So if there is deficiency of glucose 6 phosphate dehydrogenase enzyme, it causes hemolytic anemia. Why? So you can see here, because red blood cells will be unable to remove the hydrogen peroxide, and which will cause peroxidation of the membrane and cause hemolysis of the red blood cells. Okay, then next metabolic significance of this HMB pathway is, through this pathway carbon dioxide is produced, and this is very beneficial for the plant cells. They can fix this carbon dioxide through carbon dioxide fixation reaction and then convert it into sugars. And the last one is the cells of lens and cornea. Actually, the cells of lens and cornea always remain in a very oxidative environment, so there is production of many free radicals, and just like this, these free radicals are removed through lens of cornea and through the cells of lens and cornea with the help of NADPH that is produced through this pathway.